我们可以开始吗
？Yes, Maharaj, please.
Okay.
Recording in progress.
Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnanjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripasindubhaiheva cha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're reading Brihad Bhagavatamrita. And we're on the first section, third chapter, and we're hearing how Narada Muni is searching for the person who received the greatest mercy from Lord, from the Supreme Lord.
我们正在阅读的是《大博迦瓦昙甘露》这部书，我们读的是第一部分第三章，内容是 Narada 在寻找是谁得到了至尊主最大的仁慈。
And so we heard how Narada Muni had gone to Indra. He left earth and gone to heaven, went to Indra, and from Indra he went to Brahma, and Lord Brahma sent him to Lord Shiva.
那么 Narada 呢，就一开始在地球上找，后来他就被指引到了天堂，到了主 Indra 那里，天帝 Indra 又把他给引向了 Brahma 又把他引导到了主 Shiva 那里。
So Narada Muni came to Kailash and he met with Lord Shiva and he was praising Lord Shiva as being the greatest recipient of the mercy of Lord Krishna.
Narada 就去了 Kailash 山，然后在 Kailash 山呢，他见到了主 Shiva。然后他就开始那儿的开始大家赞扬主 Shiva 是得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
But Lord Shiva was very embarrassed when Narada Muni was praising him in this way.
但是当主 Shiva 听到 Narada Muni 这番赞扬之后，他感到非常的不好意思。
So Lord Shiva said to Narada Muni, he said, "Oh,This is very painful," he said. My dear Narada, you may be free of false pride, but how can you compare me? I'm the root of all pride to Krishna. Don't compare me to Krishna. I'm the root of all pride.
主 Shiva 就对 Narada 说道，哦，这是多么令人痛苦啊，亲爱的 Narada， 你也许就是摆脱了，你也许没有一丝一毫的虚荣感，但是你又怎么能把我和主 Krishna 相比呢？我是所有骄傲的根源。
Lord Krishna is the Lord of all sages who are without pride.
主 Krishna 是所有圣人们的主人，而这些圣人们他们是没有任何的骄傲的。
Lord Shiva he's actually presiding over the material force of ahankar, which is the word for false ego.
主 Shiva 主宰着Ahankara 的物质力量 ，Ahankara 是假自我这个词的梵文词。
And we have to pray to Lord Shiva to help us to overcome the effect of this false ego.
如果谁要想 摆脱征服这种假自我的感觉的话，他应该向主 Shiva 祈祷。
It's because of this false ego that everyone from the rulers of planets down to the smallest creature, they think that they're very important.
就是由于这种假自我，就是从这个统治者开始，一直到最小的。
Lord Shiva is blaming himself for the false ego that pervades this whole material creation.
主 Shiva 他在自责，他自责，因为他所以才有了这整个的物质创造。
Narada Muni, however, Narada Muni is free from the influence of false ego.
但是Narada Muni呢，他是摆脱了假自我的影响了。
So it's not really proper for Narada Muni to be idolizing or to be praising Lord Shiva, because Narada Muni in some ways is greater than Shiva.
所以 Narada Muni 呢，他就不应该赞扬主 Shiva， 把主 Shiva 偶像化，因为在某种程度上 Narada Muni 比主 Shiva 要伟大。
So, Lord Shiva, he's influenced by false ego.
主 Shiva 他受到假自我的影响。
And the opposite to Lord Shiva is Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna doesn't have any false ego.
与主 Shiva 相反的是主 Krishna. 主 Krishna 没有任何假自我。
Lord Krishna is very pure, and he's without any pride.
主 Krishna 至纯至粹，他没有任何骄傲之心。
So in this way, Lord Shiva is saying that there's no real relationship between him and Lord Krishna.
主 Shiva 这个。就是在这里就想表达的是，他自己和主 Krishna 之间没有不存在任何真正的关系。
Because Narada Muni was saying, you know, you got the greatest mercy from Krishna, but Lord Shiva said, how is it possible? I'm so proud.
之前 Narada Muni 呢赞扬主 Shiva 是得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈，但是主 Shiva 说。这怎么可能呢？我这么傲慢。
Lord Krishna has no pride, but Lord Shiva, his influence, he's dealing with pride. So he gets affected by it because he's dealing with pride. He gets affected by it also.
主 Krishna 他没有一丝毫的骄傲之心，但是由于主 Shiva 他处理这个，他跟这个骄傲打交道，所以他受到骄傲的影响。
Yeah, he is the lord of false ego. He's the lord of ahankar.
主 Shiva 是假自我的主人，是 ahankar 的主人。
So Lord Shiva says to Narada Muni, he said, "I'm covered by many false identities."
主 Shiva 就继续说，我被虚假的身份感所覆盖了。
For example, I think myself to be the Lord of the universe.
比如说，我自认为自己是宇宙之主。
And I think I'm the all-knowing giver of knowledge.
我也认为我是知识的无所不知的知识的赐予者。
And I'm the liberated bestower of liberation because Lord Shiva, he's able to give liberation.
我是解脱的赐予者，我自己也是解脱了的人。
And I give devotion to Lord Vishnu.
我甚至将奉爱，赐给了主 Vishnu.
So these are all some of the different misconceptions which Lord Shiva has.
这是主 Shiva 的一些误解。
So we may think that the universal controller of false ego should be.He shouldn't be affected by the influence of false ego.
一个人可能会以为这个假自我的这宇宙的控制者，他不应当受到假自我的影响。
But Lord Shiva says it's not true. No, he said I'm affected by it.
但是主 Shiva 就一矢口否认说。不是这样的，我还是受到假我的影响。
And Lord Shiva also says he considers himself a dear devotee of Lord Vishnu.
主 Shiva 也说，他认为自己是主 Vishnu 的一个亲爱的奉献者。
And he thinks Lord Shiva thinks he has received Vishnu's special mercy.
主 Shiva 他认为自己得到了。Vishnu 的特殊的仁慈。
And Lord Shiva is saying that this kind of mentality, this is just the not, this is the influence of the false ego on me.
主 Shiva 说，这样一种心态呢，实际上就是假我对我的在我身上的影响。
Just to think of ourselves like that is important. This is false ego.
就这样的自认为自己很重要，这就是假我。
Lord Shiva says, when the time comes for annihilation, he said, in the time of annihilation, when everything must be destroyed and devoured, Lord Shiva said, I am obliged.To just by the mode of ignorance to destroy the whole creation.
主 Shiva 说，当这个宇宙的毁灭的时刻，这可怕的时刻到来的时候，一切都会被吞噬，而我就由受到愚昧形态的影响，就是被迫摧毁整个的宇宙。
So Lord Shiva says, when I think of this, I feel very ashamed of myself.
主 Shiva 说，一旦我想到这一点，我就感到很窘迫，难为情。
So Lord Shiva says, my dear Narada, he said, if I had even a drop of the mercy of the Lord, why would he fight with me?
主 Shiva 说，我亲爱的 Narada， 倘若我得到主 Hari 的哪怕一滴仁慈的话，那他为什么会和我作战？
When Lord Krishna came to the higher planets, the heavenly planets, he took away the Parijata flower. At that time, I fought with Indra, the king of heaven. We fought against Lord Krishna, and we tried to stop him from taking the Parijata flower.
当主 Krishna 来到高等星系，设法取走 Parijata 花的时候，我站在 Indra 一方，我们和主 Krishna 对战，阻止他。
And when Aniruddha, the grandson of Lord Krishna, he got involved in a relationship with Usha, who was the daughter of a demon called Banasura. So this Banasura was a friend of Lord Shiva.
当 Krishna 的孙子 Aniruddha 和恶魔 Banasura 的女儿 Usha 之间有了恋情的时候，我也卷入到了这件事情当中。
So that time, Lord Krishna came with the army because what happened,Banasura arrested Aniruddha because he didn't. They had their relationship without the permission of Usha's father. So Banasura arrested Aniruddha and put him in prison. Then Lord Krishna came with his army to free him. And there was a big fight between Banasura's army and Lord Krishna and Lord Krishna's army. At that time, Lord Shiva, he fought for Banasura against Lord Krishna.
因为有一次呢，就是巴纳苏拉摩就逮捕了阿尼鲁达，因为阿尼鲁达在未经乌沙的父亲的允许的情况下呢，就跟他女儿有了关系，所以巴纳苏拉就把他投到了监狱。这时候，主Krishna就率领了大军前来营救阿尼鲁达。在此的巴纳苏拉的军队和Krishna的军队展开作战，主Shiva就为巴纳苏拉摩而战。
So these are two examples Lord Shiva is giving where Krishna fought with Lord Shiva.
这个是两个例子，主 Shiva 举出了他和 Krishna 之间曾经有过战争。
And then Lord Shiva says, why would he worship me, his servant? Then why would he order me?
主 Shiva 又说到了, 他为什么要崇拜我这个仆人，他为什么要又要给我下达了这个命令呢？
Yeah, and he said, Lord Krishna ordered me, he said, turn the people away from me by concocting your own version of scriptures.
主 Krishna 命令主 Shiva 说道，你要编造你自己的经典，从而
This happened when Lord Shiva was told by Lord Krishna to preach the Mayavadi philosophy.
就是当主Shiva得到主 Krishna的命令去传教假象宗哲学的时候，
So Lord Shiva wants to prove that Lord Krishna doesn't really care for him at all.
主Shiva就想要证明主 Krishna 根本就不在乎他。
And he wants to show that actually not only does he not care for him, actually Krishna looks at him in contempt.
主 Krishna 不仅不在乎他，而且呢，主 Krishna 呢实际上就是
So Lord Shiva's arguing, he's saying, Krishna would not have opposed me in the battle, on the, but he fought against me.
主Shiva呢，他又接着就争辩说，主 Krishna呢，本来是
He fought against me when he took the when he was stealing the Parijata flower, and he fought against me. And then when Aniruddha stole Usha, then he fought against me.
当主 Krishna 偷走了天帝英者的 Parijata 鲜花的时候，并且当 Aniruddha
就偷走了乌舍的时候，这时候他们俩之间就展开了战争。So, we see if a master, if somebody who's a master pretends to worship somebody who's a servant, then the servant is actually insulted and he's exposed to the ridicule of the ordinary people, because the ordinary people know he's only the servant, and so if the master is worshipping him, it's just a joke.
我们看到，当一位主人装模作样的崇拜一个仆人的时候，这个仆人呢，实际上是被受到了侮辱，并且遭到了公众的 嘲笑，因为在大众眼里呢，这个主人呢不应当崇拜仆人。
So if a master does like that, if he shows false respect to the servant, it means that the master actually has some bad feelings. He has some grudge against the servant, and he wants to humiliate him.
如果发生这种就主人当众的崇拜仆人的现象的时候呢，这就表明这个主人呢实际上对这个仆人呢有一些牢骚和抱怨，就想令这仆人当众受辱。So
it may have been like that. It may have been like that because one time Krishna worshipped Shiva, and he worshipped Shiva to get a son. He wanted a good son. And so he worshipped Lord Shiva.
所以这是有可能发生这样的情况，就是当主 Krishna 有一次呢，他为得到一位卓越出众的儿子，他崇拜了 Shiva.
Of course, Lord Krishna doesn't need to worship Lord Shiva to get a good son, but he did it, you know, just to, maybe to make fun of Lord Shiva, or maybe to teach others that this is what you should do.
因为有一次主 Krishna 就崇拜了主 Shiva， 也许他这么做是为了，就是嘲讽主 Shiva， 或者是以身作则，向大众，做出榜样，表明不能当这样去做。
So when Lord Shiva, when Krishna asks benediction from Lord Shiva, this indicates to Lord Shiva that this is not Krishna's favor, this is not Krishna's mercy, but this is Krishna making fun of Lord Shiva.
当主 Krishna 向主 Shiva 寻求祝福的时候， 这表明这并非主 Krishna 的恩宠， 反而是 Krishna 的一种蔑视。
So, and Lord Krishna, we could say, is punishing Lord Shiva in some subtle way.
也可以换言之，主 Krishna 在一种轻微的方式 惩罚主 Shiva.
Yeah, because Lord Shiva has gone against the proper principles of religion.
因为主 Shiva 违背了正确的宗教原则。
Lord Shiva is supposed to be a great devotee of Krishna.
主 Shiva 理应当是主 Krishna 的伟大奉献者。
And he's supposed to teach pure devotional service.
他理应教导纯粹的奉爱服务。
But Lord Krishna ordered him, Lord Krishna ordered him that he should teach the Mayavadi philosophy, which is atheism.
但主 Krishna 却命令主 Shiva 来教导世人 假象宗哲学理论，而这是一种无神论的理论。
Actually, Lord Shiva is a pure devotee, and he did get Lord Krishna's mercy.
事实上，主 Shiva 的的确确的是纯粹奉献者，而且确实是得到了主 Krishna 的仁慈。
And when Lord Krishna asked Lord Shiva to teach atheism, this is for the sake of protecting the devotee, protecting devotional service, making it confidential. Not for everyone, but it's Lord Shiva was ordered to preach this atheistic philosophy, Mayavadi philosophy, to protect devotional service, to make it confidential.
主 Shiva 得到主 Krishna 命令去传播假象宗哲学，目的就是为了保护奉爱服务，使奉爱服务不为众人所知。Yeah,
we don't want all these atheistic people coming into devotional service.
我们不希望这些无神论的人们来进入到奉爱服务当中。
That's why Lord Shiva was preaching Mayavadi philosophy.
由于这个原因呢，主 Shiva 才去传播假象中哲学的教义。
So we should understand that pure devotees like Lord Shiva, they will always be dissatisfied with themselves.
就我们当明白，像主 Shiva 这样的纯粹奉献者呢，他们总是对自己不满意。
Yeah, they don't claim to have any special spiritual qualities or position.
嗯，他们从来不声称自己拥占据着特殊的一席之地。
Lord Shiva said to Narada, he says to Narada Muni, "Oh, you're very happy to praise the power which I and my wife have to give liberation. You're praising me and my wife because we can give liberation."
主 Shiva 又对拿达说，你赞美我和我的妻子能够给予解脱的能力。
But we feel that it's terrible to have this power, because Krishna's devotees, they feel distressed to hear of anybody else able to give liberation, anybody other than Lord Vishnu or Lord Krishna to give liberation. It's terrible to, for devotees to hear that. They don't like to hear.
但这是可怕的，因为主的奉献者听到除了主 Vishnu 之外还有谁可以赐予解脱，当他们听到这番话的时候，他们会感到很难过和痛苦。
So now we're going to hear how Lord Shiva is going to send Narada Muni to see the people of Vaikuntha.
接下来我们会听到主 Shiva 又派遣 Narada Muni 去找 Vaikuntha 的人们，去听他们说话。
Because Lord Shiva is going to tell Narada Muni that the people of Vaikuntha, they have got the most mercy of Krishna.
因为主 Shiva 告诉 Narada Muni 说， Vaikuntha 的居民们才是得到了主 Krishna 最了不起的仁慈的人。
So Lord Shiva says to Narada, "Don't think of me as being, as having received Krishna's compassion."
主 Shiva 继续对 Narada Muni 说道，不要以为我是得到了主 Krishna 的怜悯和怜悯之情。
The people who have actually received the real mercy of Krishna are the people who live in Vaikuntha.
倘若有人是得到了主 Krishna 的真正的仁慈的话，那么这样的人是 Vaikuntha 的居民。
Now Narada Muni is one of Lord Vishnu's main servants in Vaikuntha. So he should not have to be told about the Vaikuntha people.
Narada Muni 本人就是主在 Vaikuntha 的主要仆人，所以他无需告诉他这件事情，就 Vaikuntha 的人们得到了主 Krishna 的仁慈。
Anyway, Lord Shiva is going to speak about the qualification of the people in Vaikuntha.
主 Shiva 接下来会描述 Vaikuntha 居民拥有的六项品质。
And Lord Shiva said, "The people in Vaikuntha, they gave up everything like it was worthless straw."
Vaikuntha 的居民们，他们放弃了一切，把他们都视作是毫无价值的稻草。
And they worship the Supreme Lord Vishnu in pure devotion.
他们怀着纯粹的奉爱之情崇拜主 Vishnu.
They don't care anything about achievements of the material world. And they will not even look at those kind of things, the perfections which you can get in the material world. They don't mean anything to the people of Vaikuntha.
因为物质世界的任何完美和成就对维昆特的居民没有任何意义，所以他们根本就不屑一顾。
So in Vaikuntha, there's different kinds of people. Different kinds of people live there. Some of them are devotees who've always been there.
维昆特的居民分为不同的种类，有一种呢是。 永恒地居住在外昆特的完美的人。But
others are people who come from the material world and have been brought to Vaikuntha.
还有另一些人是从物质世界晋升到外昆特的人们。And
some people, they get to Vaikuntha by doing perfect sadhana. They do sadhana and by their sadhana, they're able to enter Vaikuntha.
有些人是通过规范修行 sadhana, 从而得以进入到Vaikuntha无忧心修.
By their sadhana, they surrendered everything to Krishna, and they got to Vaikuntha.
通过规范修行，他们把一切都臣服给 Krishna. 从而就得以进入到无忧星宿。So
those people who do good sadhana, they get the favor of Lord Vishnu.
倘若谁要是做出很好的、很优秀的 sadhana 的话，就会得到主维斯诺的仁慈了。And
they get devotion for him. They have devotion for Lord Vishnu only, not for any other god.
他们的父爱之情是专注于主维斯努，而不是任何其他的神职。And
they don't care about any other thing. They don't care about religious principles of the Vedas, and they don't care about mystic perfection of yoga.
他们对其他一切都毫不理会，包括伟大经中的宗教原则以及瑜伽的。
And when material perfection, some of the devotees are very advanced, and when they get material perfections, it doesn't mean anything to them. They don't even think about it.
啊，有一些非常进步的奉献者。 当他们自动得到了物质的完美的时候，这对他们来说就是没有什么意义，他们也毫不理会。Yeah,
they think of these things which are like a treasure for common people in the material world, but to these pure devotees, they think of them, these perfections, as being like worthless, like being some garbage.
在世俗的人的眼里。 那这些呢是他们会如获至宝，但是在维昆特的居民的眼里呢，这些都是毫无价值的垃圾。So
these people of Vaikuntha, they have given up all false pride. They're not proud at all. They have no pride.
这些维昆特的居民人们，他们放弃了所有的骄傲，他没有一丝一毫的骄傲。And
they've attained Vaikuntha, which is beyond the material modes and without any fear.
他们真达了维昆特的星球，在那里呢是超越了一切物质的形态。
Vaikuntha is actually full of eternity, knowledge, and bliss.
无忧星系充满着永恒知识和极乐。And
the people of Vaikuntha are greater not only than the the people of Vaikuntha are much greater than the material is, and they're even greater than the people who are coming for liberation. And they're greater even than people like Lord Shiva, who gives liberation. Lord Shiva gives liberation, so but these people of Vaikuntha are even above him. Haribo?
Hare Krishna, sorry. My signal is unstable. Though I dropped for a moment.
Okay.
Okay.
Did you hear?
Yes. Vaikuntha 的居民们，他们甚至比主 Shiva 还伟大，而主 Shiva 是那位能够赐予解脱的人。
According to Lord Shiva's own view, Lord Shiva, he said, I'm subject to the influence of false ego, but the people of Vaikuntha, they're free from this defect. They don't have any false ego.
根据主师傅自己的观点，主师傅还要受到假我的影响，但是Vaikuntha的奉献者们则没有这种缺陷。
And because they're free of this false pride, that's why these Vaishnavas get to Vaikuntha.
由于他们摆脱了虚荣，所以这些人才达到了，得以进入到无忧星宿。And
Vaikuntha is not a temporary, illusory place like the material world, but this is eternal existence. And Vaikuntha is full of pure consciousness and unlimitedly satisfying bliss.
Vaikuntha 充满着纯粹的知觉。 充满着无穷无尽的、令人满足的喜乐。
It's not like the material world where there are many restrictions.
它并不像物质世界这个充满着各种各样限制的地方。
And in Vaikuntha, we can see that it describes the perfection of Vaikuntha that it's impossible to attain for non-devotees.
非奉献者是无法真达Vaikuntha的。
Vaikuntha is without the three modes of nature and full in the six divine characteristics.
无忧星宿它没有物质自然三形态，它充满着六种神圣的特征。
And there's eternally perfect souls there, all the souls there are eternally perfect, and they have the same six characteristics.
那里居住着永恒的完美的灵魂们，而这些灵魂们，他们也同样具备六种特征。
And these characteristics appear in the five different ages of life.
而这六种特征显现在 生命的五个阶段。
Vaikuntha is made beautiful by the presence of many palaces and different assembly halls, and by the there's also many wells and tanks and ponds and gardens and forests and many trees.
在 Vaikuntha 那上面有各种各样美丽的宫殿，还有大厅。还有各种各样的景、湖泊、池塘、花园、森林以及果树。
So that it's a transcendental world, and it's worshipped by the demigods. It's more effulgent than 10,000 suns.
那是一个超然的地方。受到半神人们的崇拜，它比一万个太阳还要璀璨辉煌。
And there's unlimited spiritual qualities there.
那里充满着无穷无尽的灵性品质。
And there's also the supreme light, which we cannot even approach.
那里还有至高无上的光芒，而这光芒是我们无法接近的。
Vaikuntha cannot be understood by the material senses. We cannot experience it by the material senses.
我们无法通过物质的感官来体验 Vaikuntha.
And it cannot be compared to anything we know in this world.
它也无法跟我们在物质世界所认知的事物相比较。
It is supremely ecstatic.
它是至尊的喜乐狂喜的。
So, when Lord Krishna was very satisfied with Lord Brahma, when Lord Brahma, at the beginning of the creation, Lord Brahma did austerities.And Lord Krishna was very pleased with him. At that time, he showed him Vaikuntha.
在创造之初，主 Brahma， 当他从事苦行，取悦了主至尊性格神手的时候，至尊性格神手便向他展示了他的私人居所。
This is described in the second canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这件事情是在《圣殿博迦瓦坛》第二篇当中得以描述。
So the Lord was happy to show him his own abode, Vaikuntha.
主很高兴地向婆罗诃摩展示了他个人的居所——无忧清秀。
And that Vaikuntha is the supreme planet above all other planets.
那个外昆塔，它是至高无上的星球，超越了所有其他的星球。
And it's appreciated by all the self-realized devotees who are free from all the miseries and fear of illusion in the material world.
它受到摆脱了虚幻的物质世界虚幻的存在，这个超然的居所呢，就被那些自我觉悟的人们所崇拜，而这些人是摆脱了痛苦，摆脱了物质世界的虚幻的恐惧心。
So because Vaikuntha is the abode of the Lord, so there's no influence of the modes of nature like passion and ignorance.
由于 Vaikuntha 是主的私人居所，所以他没有任何就是激情或者愚昧属性的影响。
And there's not even the influence of the mode of goodness.
在那里甚至没有善良形态的影响。
And there's no influence of time.
那里也没有时间的影响。
And there's no illusion of the external energy. The external energy cannot influence the spiritual world.
外在能量是无法影响灵性世界的。
So both the demigods and the demons worship the Supreme Lord as devotees.
无论是半神人也好，还恶魔也罢，他们都，崇拜主，作为奉献者来崇拜了主。
So in the 10th canto, it's of the Bhagavatam, it's described there about Vaikuntha, that this deeply considering the situation of the cowherd man, the all-merciful personality of Godhead revealed to them his abode beyond the material world.
在圣典《不教法坛》第十篇当中是这样描述的，请深思熟虑这个这些牧牛郎的地位吧。全面仁慈的至尊性格神手哈瑞向他们展示了他的居所，而这居所超越了物质的黑暗。
Yeah, the cowherd men were trying to understand who is the son of Nanda Maharaj, who is this Krishna, who is the son of Nanda Maharaj? Maybe he's a demigod or something.
这些牧牛郎他们都在那里纷纷地猜测 Nanda Maharaj 的这个儿子到底是谁，他是不是一个半神人。
They'd seen Lord Krishna perform so many wonderful feats. He defeated Indra and he picked up the Govardhan Hill and he protected all the people of Vrindavan.
他们看见 Nanda 大军的儿郎打败了天帝 Indra，举起了格尔丹山来保护了本大本的居民。
So at that time they were trying to understand who is Krishna. So Krishna revealed to them the spiritual world.
那时候他们很想了解 Krishna 的地位，所以 Krishna 向他们展示了灵性世界的多姿多彩。
Yeah, he showed them the spiritual effulgence which comes from his body.
主 Krishna 向他们展示了从他身体散发出的灵性光灿。
That effulgence is unlimited and it's conscious and it's also eternal.
这光芒是无穷无尽，充满知觉，永恒的。
So usually the sages, the great sages, only when they're in trance and when their consciousness is free from all material nature.Then at that time they can see this effulgence.
通常当那些处在神定当中的圣人们，当他们的知觉摆脱了物质自然属性影响的时候，他们才可以看到这灵性的景象。
So it appears like Vaikuntha is like the Brahmajyoti, but it's different from the Brahmajyoti.
表面上看来 Vaikuntha 好像是梵光 Brahmajyoti， 但事实上却并不是。
So we have to, anyway, we have to understand with the eye of intelligence, we have to understand Vaikuntha.
所以我们必须用智慧的眼睛才去理解 Vaikuntha 无忧星宿。
Even though we may not be fit to go there, we want to try to understand and appreciate it.
即便我们还没有资格去那里，但是我们努力去理解，去欣赏它。
In Vaikuntha, all the people in Vaikuntha have bodies which are eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
在无忧星宿，所有的居民们都拥有永恒知识和极乐的躯体。
And they can have any of the opulences of the Supreme Lord. They can enjoy all of the Lord's opulences.
他们可以享受至尊主的所有富裕。
They have powers equal to him, just like eternal full of bliss and knowledge. That's the power of the Supreme Lord. They're So they have powers equal to the Lord.
他们也拥有永恒知识极乐这些力量，而跟至尊主一样的这样的力量。
But there's a difference that the people of Vaikuntha, they don't like to accept equality. They don't want to be on the same level as the Lord. They won't like to accept these things.
但是 Vaikuntha 的居民们不喜欢接受跟主这个同等的这样的地位。
So we should understand the people in Vaikuntha, they each have their own individual bodily forms, but these are not forms like in the material world.
我们要理解 Vaikuntha 的居民们，每个他们都有独特的个体的躯体的形象，但是这些形象呢，不是物质世界的那种形象。
Because these are spiritual forms. So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Maharaj Yudhisthira, he asked Narada Muni about this. He said, the bodies of the people of Vaikuntha are completely spiritual. They have nothing to do with the material bodies.
Yudhisthira 大君呢，就曾经对 Narada Muni 就说，百昆特的居民的躯体是完全灵性的，他们和物质的躯体、感官、生命之气毫无关联。
The people who live in Vaikuntha are all transcendental, and so also are all of their opulences. It's all transcendental.
百昆特的居民们都是超然的，他们所有这些外在的富裕也全部是超然的。
And the people who live there, they have more power and they have more wealth than what you could have in millions of material universes.
在那里的居民所拥有的力量和财富，比上百万的物质世界能够得到的财富还要多。
So these opulences, which the people in Vaikuntha get, they get it without any effort and without limit also. And it's all spiritual, eternal, and real.
这些 Vaikuntha 居民们所取得的富裕，他们取得的时候是不费吹灰之力就可以得到，而且是能够无限地得到这些富裕，而且这些富裕是永恒之灵性的，而且是绝对的真实的。
And these people are all expansions of the Supreme Lord's divine energy.
这些人都是至尊主神圣能量的扩展。
And so they're all.It's all things which we would like to desire, and at the same time, everything is full of variety.
这些事物是我们都渴求的，而且他们是多姿多彩的，丰富多彩的。
So this is proof of this is will be given later in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, and also.Yeah, proof of this, we'll get proof of this later.
那么这对此的证明呢，我们将在《大宝教法堂甘露》这本书的后面得到证实给出。
So the people of Vaikuntha are satisfied simply to worship the Lord with devotion.
Vaikuntha 的居民，单纯的只是通过崇拜主，怀着奉爱崇拜，他们就已经心满意足了。
And they're free to travel wherever they want. Wherever they want, they can travel.
他们可以自由自在地去任何地方旅行。
And wherever they go, they're promoting and they're protecting the mission of the Lord and his devotees.
无论他们去哪里，他们都在保护着，他们都在散播着主的使命。
They're protecting and promoting devotional service.
他们在保护奉爱服务，而且他们在传播着奉爱服务。
So the devotees in Vaikuntha, they do not want to be equal to Lord Vishnu, because they simply want to serve him with devotion.
百昆的奉献者们并不想和主维什努并驾齐驱，因为他们只希望怀着奉爱来服务他。
And nothing gives them pleasure except bhakti yoga.
除了奉爱瑜伽，没有什么能给予他们快乐。
So when somebody's mind is completely satisfied with Krishna, then he will find only happiness.Wherever he goes.
倘若谁的心意是完全彻底的，心满意足的时候，对 Krishna 感到满意的时候，他会无论他去哪里，他都只能会找到快乐。
So these Vaikuntha people are eternally liberated, and they always try to help others.
这些崴昆的人们，他们是永恒解脱的，而且他们总是愿意帮助其他人。
In the material world, they will protect sincere devotees. They will protect them from misunderstanding the principles of devotional service.
在物质世界，他们会保护人们，不让人们对奉爱服务的原则有误解。
They know that if they misunderstand the principles of devotional service, then they will fall down and they will be punished by Yamaraj. So they try to protect them.
他们知道，谁要是对奉爱服的原则，有误解，那么就会堕落，从而受到阎罗王的使者的惩罚。
And people from Vaikuntha.Sometimes they will encourage advanced devotees to go and take birth in the family of other devotees in the material world.
Vaikuntha 的居民们会鼓励，这些进步的奉献者的，后代们来进入投生在神圣的家庭当中。
And this way they will help to increase the prosperity and the influence of these devotees.
以这种方式，他们会增加这些奉献者的繁荣和影响力。
And it will be a great help.To the devotees' preaching.
这样就对奉献者的传教是一个巨大的帮助。
It will help to bring conditioned souls back to Godhead.
这会有助于帮助受条件限制的灵魂回归神手。
So these Vaikuntha people, when they come to the material world, they're like instructing.Spiritual masters.
所以，当这些瓦昆特的人们来到物质世界的时候，他们就担当着人们的训示灵性导师的角色。
And the representatives take away the obstacles like attachment to material things.
他们的代表。把人们就对物质事物的依附和执着移除拿走。
Even they take away the attachment to liberation.
他 他们甚至能够拿走人们对于解脱的衣服和执着。
And they encourage them in their devotional service.
他们鼓励他们从事奉爱服务。
They get encouraged by the people from Vaikuntha to dedicate everything for Krishna's service.
人们从这些维昆塔的居民那里得到鼓励，把一切都献出来为 Krishna 做服务。
Certainly, the people from Vaikuntha, they're not worried about their karma.
Sorry, there is a break, so I didn't hear.
The people from Vaikuntha, they have no anxiety. They don't have to worry about their karma. So whatever they do, whatever they try to do, it will be successful.
这些维昆特的人们，他们并不担心的任何的因果报应，无论他们做什么事情，都不会徒劳无益，都将是成功的。
They always worship the Lord of Vaikuntha.
他们永恒的崇拜维昆特之主。
And they're amused when they see people who are just only liberated. They're amused because they know these people that they're only liberated. They haven't understood the real goal of life, which is devotional service.
当他们听说，他们听说，那谁要是得到了解脱的时候，他们就会感到。滑稽可笑，因为他们知道这些解脱的人们并不知道生命的真实目标。
And the people from Vaikuntha are always busy in different services.
而且维昆特的人们总是忙碌着从事奉爱服务。
And for the service of Krishna, sometimes they will even take on forms like those of birds and trees.
而且为了服务 Krishna, 他们有的时候甚至变成鸟类的形象或者树木的形象。
Okay, so can we stop here?
Yes, Maharaj, we have quite some questions.
Okay.
Uh, 我们来看一下问题。第一个是来自于小草的。Maharaj, the first question is from 小草。请问 Guru, 当宇宙毁灭时，主 Shiva 也一起毁灭吗
？No, Lord Shiva, he doesn't have a material body.
不会的，因为主 Shiva 并没有个物质的躯体。
Lord Shiva is a special personality.
主 Shiva 是特殊的人物。
He is like, it said Vishnu is like the milk and Lord Shiva is like yogurt.
主 Vishnu 就好比是牛奶，而主 Shiva 好比酸奶。
So Lord Shiva, he's not subject to old age and disease and death.
主 Shiva 呢，他不会变老，不会生病，不会死亡。
Okay.
嗯 ，the next question， 解脱是什么样的状态？我们什么时候才能得到解脱
？Well, you have to understand, a devotee is already liberated. One who uses his body, mind, and words in the service of Krishna.He's a liberated soul.
奉献者们，他们已经是解脱的灵魂了。谁要是将躯体、心意和言语都拿来服务 Krishna， 他就处在解脱的状态下了。
So in this very life, you can be liberated. You don't have to wait to give up the body to get liberation.
在这一生就已经可解脱了。 你不需要等待放弃这个躯体之后才能得到解脱。
Yes.
下一个是来自于，是快乐、崇拜和服务假我的控制者，主 Shiva 可不可以摆脱假我？
Well, we just heard Lord Shiva said no. He's still influenced by false ego.
The questions, can we get rid of false ego by worshipping and serve the controller of false ego, Lord Shiva?
Oh, can we get rid of false ego? Yes, you can.
是的，可以，可以通过崇拜主 Shiva 摆脱假我。
Yes. You can ask Lord Shiva.To help you.
就是您可以请求主 Shiva 帮助您。
Usually, though, we worship Krishna, and by worshiping Krishna, you get all the good qualities.
一般而言，我们崇拜主 Krishna， 而崇拜了主 Krishna， 就可以得到所有的优秀品质了。
You simply worship Lord Krishna, then all the good qualities will come.
只要是去崇拜了主 Krishna, 所有的品质，好品质就会自动的展现出来。
But if you worship Lord Shiva, then sometimes you may make mistake and you may make Lord Shiva angry. It's easy to please Lord Shiva, but it's also easy to make him angry.So you have to be very careful in the worship of Lord Shiva.
但崇拜主 Shiva 可得小心了，因为你可以很轻易的取悦主 Shiva， 但是也可以很容易的就让主 Shiva 愤怒。
So we encourage the devotees to worship Lord Krishna.
所以我们鼓励奉献者们去崇拜主 Krishna.
Okay.
下面是上周四的问题，上周四的问题。Govinda Nandini Devadasi， 请接受我卑微的顶拜 ，Gurudev。想问一下，如果奉献者把时间精力全部花在建庙上，而忘记了念诵、做 arti 等等服务，是不是看起来？表面上是在做奉爱服，但实际上是处在玛雅之中呢。
Translate.
Yeah, the question is that, please accept my humble obeisances, Gurudev. If the devotee spend all his energy in, building the temple, and instead forget to chant to do arti.Is it that he appear to do service, but in fact he is in Maya?
Yes.
是的。
You're right. The first service is to chant the holy name.
第一个服务就是唱诵圣名。
If you don't chant the holy name, then all of your service is not very useful.
如果不念诵圣名的话，那他做的所有这些服务都没有用。
Eventually, you will just give up Krishna consciousness.
他的服务呢都白费了，他这些表面上的服务，而且最终呢，他将放弃 Krishna 知觉。
So that's what happens if you don't chant regularly.
谁要是不有规律的念诵的话，就会发生这样的事情。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于，还是狗温的南丁尼的，请接受我卑微顶拜 Gurudev。 价格是，Padma Shruti Rupa Devadasi Dinbai Guru。今天我们小组在联谊和学习，邀请外地资深稳定的奉献者和我们网络联谊，每个人感受到完全遵循 Guru 的训示，就是灵性进步最快、最安全的保障。请问 Guru，对于像我们这样既不成熟又没有文化基础的孩子，你有什么建议和祝福，指导我们从规范的学习当中成长吗？感恩 Guru。So Shruti Rupa, yes, understand.
Pretty much, I think I've got it. Yeah, she just wants to know what they have to do for their advancement. What should be their mood? What should be their attitude in studying together?
Yes.
Well, yes, you have to.Try to read the books together and understand the process of Krishna consciousness.
你们需要一起读书去理解 Krishna 之间。But she's first report that they had association and they invite the senior devotee in the other province to associate with them online.
Yeah, may I hit that? Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, so yeah. You have to hear, and you have to hear from them, and you have to inquire from them, and you have to apply what they're telling you.
是，就是你们，可以聆听他们的，聆听他们说的话，向他们询问问题，而且。他们说的话呢，你们当付诸实践。
So you have to understand this Krishna conscious process. This is a genuine spiritual process. You can make great spiritual advancement if you follow it properly.
所以你们应当明白，这 Krishna 之觉呢是一个正宗的、真正的一个法门。如果你们是正确的去运用的话，那么一定会使取得灵性进步的。
You have to take the process seriously. You have to want to make progress in spiritual life.
你们必须认认真真的对待这个法门，并且希望能真诚的渴望取得灵性的进步。
You should be disgusted with the material world.
你们应当就是对物质世界就是厌烦物质世界。
You should know there's no real happiness in the material world.
要明白，你们要明白，物质世界不会有真正的快乐。
So try to understand the teachings carefully and practice carefully. Follow the four principles and chant every day.
要努力的去理解这些教导，小心的。将它就是用在日常生活当中，遵守四项规范原则，每天都要念诵，有规律的念诵。
So we wish you good luck. You please continue. You meet regularly and help these new people to make spiritual advancement.
所以您继续。有规律的帮助这些新人取得灵性的进步。
You're very fortunate that senior devotees are giving their time to meet with you and to speak with you. So take advantage of their association.
你们非常幸运能得到这些资深的外地奉献者，他们花时间来和你们在网络上联谊。所以你们要充分的利用这种联谊。
Okay. Yes.
下一个问题是 Raja Priya 对所有人说：顶拜咕噜在奉爱服务中忘记了以解脱为目的和天天想着解脱为目的的两者，是否在知觉上有差异吗？忘记了。
What is this?
I didn't understand. He said, obeisance guru, what's the difference between, we forget the purpose, is liberation when doing devotional service, and, that we think about liberation as our only, destiny every day. What's the difference between we think about liberation and then we do devotional service and we forget that liberation is our goal?
Well, liberation is not the goal.
解脱不是我们的目标。
Our goal is to develop love of God.
我们的目标是发展对神的爱。
If we're thinking liberation is the goal, that is selfish.
我们把解脱作为我们的目标，这个是一种自私的动机。
We have to understand a devotee was already liberated when they engage in devotional service.
我们要明白，就是奉献者们从事奉爱服务的时候，他们已经处在解脱的状态当中了。
Liberation means to get free of the influence of the material energy.
解脱的含义就是摆脱了物质能量的影响。
Means no longer influenced by passion and ignorance.
不再受到激情和愚昧的影响了。
To remain steady in the mode of goodness.
稳定的处在善良属性当中。
Right, then going to be actually situated, we should be situated in Shuddha. Shuddha sattva, the mode of pure goodness, without any influence of passion or ignorance.
我们应当处在稳定的处在 Shuddha sattva, 就纯粹的善良属性，摆脱了激情和愚昧属性。
But according to scriptures, the impersonalists, their goal is to get liberation.
根据经典所言，非人格主义者的目标就是解脱。
And they get it only with great difficulty.
他们在费尽周折努力之后才能得到解脱。
But a devotee very easily gets liberation.
然而奉献者们轻而易举的就能够获得解脱。
Liberation is not very important for a devotee.
解脱对于奉献者而言并不是很重要的。
A devotee simply wants devotional service, birth after birth.
奉献者们只是希望一世复一世，生生世世从事奉献服务。
So, we don't get too much attracted to liberation. But if Krishna wants to give it to a devotee may accept it. But it's not the goal for a devotee.
所以我们奉献者们不受解脱的吸引。但是如果 Krishna 想给奉献者解脱，奉献者也会接受，但这解脱并不是他们的目的。
Of course, we never want to accept impersonal liberation.
当然，奉献者们永远不会接受非人格的解脱。
But we can accept four other kinds of liberation.
我们可以接受四其他的四种解脱。
But a devotee engaged in devotional service is already on the liberated platform.
但是从事奉献服务，在做奉献服务的奉献者们，他们已经处在解脱了的层面上了。
But we have to use the body, the mind, and words all in the service of Krishna.
我们能把身体、心意、言语全部都用来为 Krishna 做服务。
So try to understand what is liberation.
请您努力去理解解脱到底意味着什么。
And you can read Nectar of Devotion. In the Nectar of Devotion, it describes many places, references from the scriptures, how devotional service is much greater than liberation.
您可以去阅读《奉爱的甘露》这部经典，其中呢就形容解脱，解脱做奉献服务比解脱要伟大的多。
Yes. Okay.
Okay. 下一个是快乐。梵哥说，梵哥说，只有威士努能赐予解脱，主 Brahma、Shiva 都不能。今天听到说主 Shiva 也能给予解脱，是怎么回事呢
？Well, we heard that devotees they don't like to think of anybody else giving liberation except Vishnu and Krishna.
我们听在课上听到说，就是奉献者们。他们不愿意去想，不愿意去想，就除了 Krishna 和 Vishnu 之外，还有任何人，其他的人可以给予解脱。
So Lord Shiva, he feels ashamed that he has the power to give liberation.
所以主 Shiva 呢，他为他能够给予解脱，所以他感到非常的就是。窘迫难堪
So he doesn't give liberation very often.
所以主 Shiva 他不会就是经常的给予赐予解脱
And devotees of Krishna they will never approach Lord Shiva for liberation.
主 Krishna 的奉献者永远不会去找主 Shiva 去要解脱。
We want to get the mercy of Krishna and Vishnu.
奉献者们希望得到的是 Vishnu Krishna 的仁慈。
Okay.
下一个是仆人顶拜孤儿莲花族请问灵性世界的灵魂有多大也是发尖的万分之一吗
Yes, that's right. 灵性 and what? 灵性世界
In the spiritual world, what's the size of the soul? Is it also the...
Well, you have to understand that the soul can take a spiritual form. We can assume a spiritual form. That tiny soul, which is here in our body, here in the material world, that when we go back to the spiritual world, then that spirit soul will manifest the spiritual form which we possess.
就是我们现在在物质世界，在这个物质躯体当中的这个灵魂，这个微小的灵魂，一旦回到了灵性世界，他们就会展示出灵性的身体。
So, what's the size of the spirit soul? You see, the spirit soul is taking a spiritual form.So the spiritual form will be certainly different from the size of the spirit soul.
The soul is different from the form of the soul in the spiritual world, right?
Yeah, right.
Oh, 在灵性世界的灵魂和灵性形象也是不一样的。
Okay.
百坤的形象都一样，格鲁克形象也一样吗？百坤的形
？No. Goloka is different from Vaikuntha.
格鲁克和百坤的不一样。
Goloka is in the form of a lotus flower.
格鲁克呢？它的形状是一朵莲花。
Right, if you look on the cover of the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, you will see the universe.
如果你看那《圣贤菩萨坛》第一篇的封面，就会看到这个宇宙的形状。
You can see also Mahavishnu is laying in the corner of the whole creation. There's a spiritual sky.And there's many Vaikuntha planets, many, many Vaikuntha planets.
在这个《菩提瓦坛》这个第一篇的封面当中，就描绘着 Mahavishnu， 他就躺在这个一角，在那里创造着宇宙。除此之外，还有灵性的天空，里面有无数的星球，无忧星宿。
Okay. Yeah, and.So the Vaikuntha planets are all situated in the Brahmajyoti.
Vaikuntha 星球都处在放光 Brahmajyoti 当中。
And above the Vaikuntha planets, there's the Goloka planet. And Goloka is in the form of a lotus flower.
在 Vaikuntha 星球之上的是 Goloka.Goloka 的样子是一朵形如莲花。
And in the center of that lotus flower is Goloka Vrindavan, where Krishna resides with all the cowherd boys and cowherd gopis and mother and father and all the cows. They all live in Goloka.
而在朵莲花的莲心中心呢，就是 Krishna 的星球。Krishna 和他的牧牛童朋友、狗屁、母牛，还有他的父母居住在那里。
Okay.
下一个是 Harini， 顶拜 Gurudev。请问，如果我们在家里的非奉献者没有开始为主做奉献服务，但是我们向主为他们祈祷。让他们做奉献者，他们原来的生活轨迹会不会因为祈祷变化？比如说，他们会受更多的苦，然后从而体会物质世界的苦，然后向 Krishna 接近 Krishna。
What a new someone's not a devotee and they're living in their house?You translate
the family.Yeah, if our family members they are non-devotee and we pray for them to do service and will Krishna change their life and make them suffering more so that they can experience the suffering and to surrender and go near to Krishna.
Well, it's not necessarily true that everybody has to suffer before they.To become a devotee.
不是说每个人在成为奉献者之前一定非得受苦才能成为奉献者。
People come to Krishna consciousness for different reasons.
来到 Krishna 这些当中的呢，人们他们有不同的原因。
Some people come out of curiosity.
有的人是出于好奇。
Some people come in search of wealth.
而有的人是来求财。
Some people come with knowledge.
有的人是为了获得知识。
So people come for different purposes. They come from different paths. We don't know why they come, but you know, everybody who comes to Krishna consciousness, they must be pious.
所以人们是通过经由不同的途径来到 Krishna 知觉当中的。 我们也不知道他们是从哪个途径而来，但是能够来到 Krishna 知觉的人，一定都是虔诚的人。And
definitely, if they're living with you and you're praying for them, then it will help them to become devotees.
而毫无疑问的，倘若他们是跟您生活在一起，而且您有帮助他们祈祷的话，then they will. 那么肯定有助于他们成为奉献者。Yeah.
So, if they're living with you, they must be hearing the holy name of Krishna, and they must be seeing Krishna's pictures.
如果他们和您生活在一起，已经能听到 Krishna 的圣名，看到 Krishna 的图片。
So. You have to, yeah, you, in your heart, you can pray to Krishna, please help them to become devotees, to come to Krishna consciousness, that's very nice. But it's not that they have to suffer distress before they become devotees.
就是您在内心呢帮助他们向 Krishna 祈祷, 请 Krishna 帮助他们成为奉献者, 这非常好, 但是呢不要以为 就是他们必须得受苦，才能经过受苦这个程序，才能成为奉献者。Everyone
suffering in the material world.
就在物质世界，每个人都在受苦。But
not everybody will admit their suffering.
但是不是人人都会承认他们在受苦这一事实。Not
everybody can understand the nature of the material world.
不是每个人都能明白这物质世界的本性。Okay. Okay, thank you. The next one. 下一个是 Nityananda Ram 对所有人说 Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤的莲花族，顶拜奉献者。 请问非人格的解脱也属于业报范畴吗？
Is impersonal liberation caused by karma?
Belong to the category of karma.
Belong to the category of karma. No, impersonal liberation is actually spiritual.
不属于业报范畴，非人格的解脱呢，实际上它是一种灵性的。People
who get impersonal liberation, they have to get free of karma before they can get impersonal liberation.
就这些得到非人格解脱的人们，他们首先得摆脱业报因果，他们才能够达到非人格解脱。下一个是 Chaitanya Rupa Devadasi， 顶拜敬爱的Guru及奉献者们，向所有人讲 Krishna 的逍遥时光可以吗？不是说不能向不信神的人炫耀圣名的荣耀吗？ 那就在恰当的事情上讲神的故事，可以吗？
Jangshamagosha, what kind of stories can we tell? Or can we? She's asking.
She's asking,
We shouldn't tell about Krishna's pastimes?
Can we relate the story of Krishna to everybody? Isn't that we cannot spread the holy name, the glory of the holy name to everyone, to those who are unfaithful? Then can we relate the story of God in proper occasion?
Well, yeah, you have to know which story, not all stories. You have to understand, people have to learn basic things before you try to tell them about Krishna. First, they have to understand who they are.
那么就是不是所有的故事，神的故事都可以讲给人听的。他们首先要学会基本的道理。他们首先，在明白 Krishna 认识 Krishna 之前，他们要明白他们自己是谁。Let
them understand they're not the body. That's very, and you can tell stories about that. Help them to understand they're not the body. Because if they don't understand who they are, they will never understand who is Krishna.
你可以讲，就是他们不是他们的躯体这个相关的故事，帮助他们理解，他们并非他们的物质躯体，在他们首先明白他们自己的身份，然后才能明白 Krishna 的身份。So
we have to give them the basic knowledge first. This ABC first, you learn ABC, then you learn more. So you have to learn, I'm not the body, I'm a soul, and the soul is eternal. And then go on from that, then you can understand, become more qualified to learn about Krishna.
要给他们首先讲 ABC 最基本的道理, 他们不是这个物质躯体，我们都是灵魂，灵魂是永恒的。从这一点，从这个基础之上呢，再往上，他们有具备资格之后，再给他们讲 Krishna.
And definitely, of course, you don't want to tell them about Krishna's pastimes with the gopis.
肯定呢，就不能给他们上来就讲 Krishna 和牧牛姑娘的小时光。
But you want them to understand there are such things as inconceivable energies.
您可以帮让他们能明白，就是存在着这样的不可思议的能量。
And the source of these inconceivable energies is Lord Krishna.
而不可思议的能量的源头就是 Krishna.
Yes.
下一个是 Harini, 顶拜古鲁莲花族，请问古鲁，如果古鲁或圣人给我们祝福，是不是我们应该更应该谨慎地对待古鲁的祝福，并在向主祈祷时应该谨慎地？ 应该对自己的祈祷的目的也应该小心。甘古的仁慈和回答。She's asking, the guru and the sadhu, if they gave us blessing, that we should be careful to deal with the.
Hari Bol.
Give our prayer.
I lost you for a little minute there. We had a break here.
Okay, sorry. Harini said obeisance to the lotus feet of Guru. If Guru or Sadhu give us blessing, should we be very cautious to deal with the blessing of Guru? This is the first part of the question.
Well, it depends what the blessing is. But a sadhu gives blessings, it must be for your good. And so you should be happy to get blessings of a sadhu. Whatever blessings the sadhu gives, it will be for our benefit, for our spiritual benefit. So we should be thankful and grateful that you got the blessing from a sadhu. No need, you don't have to be worry about it. That it's for your good.
就是倘若圣人给您祝福的话，您应该感到高兴。他们的祝福一定是为了您的灵性的好处，所以应当感谢他们的祝福，然后不用担心。他这因为这都是为了您的好处。Yes. The second part is that she's asking that, when we pray to the Lord, should we be very cautious of our the goal of our prayer?
Well, you should be conscious, yes. When you offer, you're offering prayers, you should offer them from the heart. So they must be genuine prayers. Don't just make a show. There must be real feeling from the heart.
就是当年祈祷的时候，就是应该带着觉知去祈祷，应该发自内心、发自肺腑的真诚的祈祷，而不是在那里作秀，没有感情的。
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. 下一个是 Yamuna Priyadasi, Hare Krishna, 灵拜Guru的莲花族, 请问灵魂的形象要在灵性世界才能看见吗? 灵魂的形象在躯体里已经知觉感知到了, 感谢Guru的仁慈。
She's already understood there's a spirit soul in the material body. She wants to know, can we see the spirit soul in the spiritual world?
She has already experienced the form of the soul in the body.
Yeah. But?
So she's asking, should we, should we go to the spiritual world to see the form of the soul? Because we have already, she has already know the form of the soul.
Well, it's one thing to know, but it's another thing to love and to surrender to the soul.
了解灵魂的形象是一码事儿，然后灵魂去爱，去臣服，这是另外一码事儿。
We want to know the super soul, not just the soul. We want to know the super soul.
我们不仅仅要了解灵魂，还要知觉到超灵。
So she knows the soul, but we have to understand the relationship between the individual soul and the super soul.
那么您已经了解灵魂了，感知到灵魂，但除此之外还要了解灵魂和超灵之间的关系。
We have to act on that relationship.
并且按照这个灵魂和超灵的关系去行动。
Not just we want to see God. We don't just want to see. We want to serve.
就好像我们不仅我们不是想要去见到神，我们是要服务神。
So we want to know what service are you doing for Krishna?
所以我们想知道的是，您打算为 Krishna 做哪种服务呢？
The impersonalists, they also know they're not the body. They also know their souls.
非人格主义者，他们也知道自己作为灵魂的身份，但是他们他
But they don't do any service.
但是他们却不做任何服务。
Okay.
Okay, that's, 下一个是, that's all the questions, Maharaj.
Okay, no more questions?
Yes, there is no more questions, Maharaj.
Okay, so then we will stop here.
Thank you. Here, Yamuna Priya Dasi is raising her hand, but...
Okay, she's typing something.
Yamuna Priya 的 Mana 今天举手。
Yamuna Priya， 你可以开麦说，你可以说话。你好像举手了，他好像在举手。我已经给你开解除静音了。
Hare Krishna， 咕噜贝，明白您的电话组。
Hare Krishna， 你说你有问题吗 ，Yamuna？Guru Mai.
Yeah.
他没有问题。
Yamuna Priya Mata， 我们听不见您的问题。
我的问题是，
您说，您说吧，我们都在听着呢。
我们等你。他就说 Hare Krishna。
您想说什么？
问我们好。
您是想跟姑姑问候吗？
说呗。
啊。
都听问题。谢谢姑姑呗。
哦，你已经听了问题啊。Go。OK。OK， Hare Krishna， 我们感谢奉献者。
Recording stopped.
Ganshi Guru Mani.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you, Maharaj. Jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Hare Gaur.